I've been held in your hands from the moment that I wake up until I lay my head. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name.
You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind.
For all Your goodness I will keep on singing.
10,000 reasons for my heart to find.
Bless the His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. And on that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul sings Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forever. The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at His voice, trembles at His voice. How great is our God! Sing with me, how great is our God! And all will see how great, how great is our God. Age to age he stands, and time is in his hands, beginning and the end.
The faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother Captain Leroy Forgelman. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore, with confidence, pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. Lord, be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother Kenrick Leroy. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know our love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us more. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. You who believe in me, though he died, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I'm sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God, Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this man, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both from the dead of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing home. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
St. Leonard's Church then, and listened to the funeral service for my mother. As a young man in this church, I listened to the eulogy for my grandmother. In 2009, in this modern church, I gave the eulogy of my father. I never thought or expected that in 2004, I'd be presenting the eulogy of my friend Kenrick in this church. Such is life, such is life. Kenrick was born on the 9th of January, 1944, to late Edna and Byron Waith. His siblings are Vincent Ifill of the UK, Curtis Griffith, and the late Carl Griffith. Kenrick and Joan Lamontagne of the US were very close and were considered adopted daughter and son to the late James and Harline Melville. Kenrick attended Hall Boys School, St. Leonard's Boys, and Washington High School, and was a server at St. Mary's Anglican Church. Please refer to your leaflet for a very touching tribute by his friend Richard Miller, who shared his early school days and career with Kenrick. At association with Kenrick, I was struck that he loved Prop Over and took part in Kadoomint. It was my role or task to drop him off at National Stadium every season to join his band. And he had to be early. And his house was full of all kinds of costumes from various activities. Prop Over. He built a song I would consider like a modern-day lead pipe, but it was his sweetbread. But he made what he called a wicked rum punch. I think I know have a knack of making a reasonable wicked rum punch. He loved corned beef. My favorite. His sewing skills were extraordinary. I don't know how he didn't become a tailor. He was good at sewing. His home was immaculate. If you go to his home right now, you will see it is just as he left it. Kenrick joined the staff of the psychiatric hospital, known then as the mental hospital, in 1964 and rose to the level of nursing officer. I worked with him on the Male Infirmary Ward, a ward that accommodated ailing patients, where minor surgeries were performed. I remember having to set up a tray for a lumbar puncture. Some nurses here would know about that, lumbar puncture. And sometimes a suturing tray. Kenrick always made sure that the instruments were sterilized in preparation for emergencies. He insisted that the patients were made as comfortable as possible, the ward clean, tidy, and smelling good at all times. He was a very fussy man, well-dressed. One of his female colleagues gave him an A for deportment. He was very committed to his profession too. I worked with him on night duty when he was the nursing officer in charge of the night shift. After the patients were all safely in the rooms or the dorms, nurses would sometimes assemble on particular wards. Nursing Officer Kenrick Waith made his rounds and discovered that a colleague and I were not on our assigned wards. Next morning, before we left the hospital, the senior nursing officer called us and hauled tails over the coals. Mr. Waith had reported us. I would not repeat the profane language I used when he saw him. I thought he was my friend. He quietly said, I was doing my duty. You are supposed to be on the ward. He was among mental health officers or district community nurses and covered most of the parts of St. George. He was committed to his community and he and his outpatient developed a very close relationship. Mr. Waith retired around 1999 or 2000. And he devoted a lot of his time and energy looking after his mother. He also looked after his father, who predeceased his mother, who lived to be 100 years. And I must admit that Garrick felt so happy that his mother had reached 100 years. During his last years of his life, I would take him shopping at his favorite supermarket, Popular Discount. He instinctively knew every aisle and the items on the various shelves. And although his eyes were failing, made me return items to the shelf because they were too expensive. So I still wondered, is his eyesight terribly bad? It appeared that Kenrick had some premonition about his passing. And one day he gave me a piece of paper, the contents of which looked like a letter. It was his obituary. What you saw in last Sunday's Nation was what Kenrick actually wrote. As Kenrick's body slowly deteriorated, his memory was impeccable. He remembered colleagues and friends and would inquire about them. He could retrieve telephone numbers that I thought were deleted. He was close to the man of Rosedale Senior Citizens Home, where he spent his latter days. One nurse described him as loving, respectful, and kind. I want to take this chance and opportunity to thank the staff of the nursing home for the support and care they gave to Kenrick to make him comfortable as possible. To his close and dear friend and colleague, Richard Miller. There exchanged many words of encouragement and comfort. To his friends, Gloria, Joan Lamontagne, and Robert Taylor of Canada, I only learned last night that their friendship goes back 70 years to when they sang in St. Mary's Church Choir and performed other church duties. And to Ronald Bess, neighbors, Miss Mears, who can refer to as Mary Henderson, and Caroline, who look out for him, and my wife Muriel, who Kenrick and his mother referred to as Moo, and to his dear and very close friend, Mark A. Haynes, who was a tower of strength and support right down to Kenrick's last hours. To all his friends and colleagues and relatives gathered here this evening to take part in the ceremony of Thanksgiving, and to those who may be watching on live stream. My sympathy to his godson, Ryan Burnham, and Ryan's sister, Gina, Kenrick's nieces, nephews, and cousins. I conclude with this very simple but significant quote. In the end, it's not about how we died, but how we lived. Kenrick, farewell, my friend. Farewell.
Thank you, Leroy, for that awful eulogy for Kenrick. I invite you now to stand as we say a prayer together before we sing the opening hymn. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The hymn, Through All the Changing Scenes of Life.
Thank you.
Yes, please. That's it.
For everything there is a season. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the sons of men to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity into a man's mind, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. I am the good shepherd. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John chapter 10, verses 1 to 16. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is hireling and not a shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches from them and scatters them. He flees because a hireling and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. As the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have another sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will heed my voice. So there shall be one flock, one shepherd. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Before they give thanks, the moment we begin, angel voices and a sing. Acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please sit. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. Words from our second reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 10, verse 11. I am the good shepherd, says Jesus. I met Kenry through the late Betty, and Betty's surname escaped me this evening for some reason. But Betty was a member of this church who was ill when I first came to this parish 8 years ago. And when I went to visit her, she mentioned Kenrick living not too far from her. She also told me of the diligent care that the diligence for which he was being looked after, even at that time, by Leroy and Mark. By the time I visited Kenrick then, he had heard of the new priest at St. Leonard through Betty. I was able to tell him that I know Leroy and Muriel, his wife, and that Mark and I attended school at the same time at St. Leonard's.
So the journey began. The last time that I visited Kenwick at home was to share the sacrament of Holy Communion. This is before he left his own home. And then sometime afterwards, Mark was trying to reach me to join in what would have been then his last visit to his home on the bank holiday, I think in January. And I was unable to be reached at that time. And then, of course, just recently, the news came that Kenwick died. Death, it comes. As if outside a door waiting for us to open. And it can remind us of the blessings and the challenges of living in this mortal body. Perhaps some of us would like to live to an old age. Kenwick got to his 80th year. And this evening's reading then from the Gospel of John, reminding us that Jesus was calling himself a good shepherd, and observance we made only last Sunday in the Anglican Church and I guess in the Roman Catholic Church, where we called it Good Shepherd Sunday, remembering this particular passage that was read this evening. That it is interesting that Jesus as the Good Shepherd, also in the psalm that we chanted this evening, Psalm 23, that familiar psalm, helps us in some way to think about not only Kenwick's death, but death in general. I've had an occasion, as I'm sure many other priests and many ministers, of visiting persons who are dying. And the nurses like Leroy would tell us the last thing to go would be their hearing. And one of the things, for example, the unexpected can happen. We might have persons that die suddenly, for example, that might have seemed to be in perfect health until they die suddenly. The unexpected can be very unpleasant for families, very unsettling. Yes, as we said, death. So we often hear after that door, but to whom shall we turn but to you, O Lord? So it is that us going back to the shepherd, the good shepherd, even in the midst of life when we are in death. It is into this experience then of loss and grief that we come this evening, that we must now fit our belief about God the good shepherd. It is our Christian conviction about God's love and support that can help us to cope with our loss and our grief when our loved ones die. God remains our solid rock, our shepherd, in this life where death can bring so much change. We can be assured, like the writer of Lamentations, that the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. So today, as we are touched by the death of Kenwick, and perhaps overwhelmed with the loss and grief, our faith in a God of love and support reminds us that God is still with us. God, as Good Shepherd, still cares for us. We need to hold on to that conviction. For our Lord teaches us about a God who is a God of life, a God who is not threatened by death, a God to whom death is not a match. Our Lord teaches that God's last word for us is not death, but life, what the scriptures call eternal life. So in this service, we are thanking God for the life of Kenwick, and not simply mourning Kenwick's life, because not simply mourning his death. We are thanking God for his time in this world for the last 80 years and the contributions that he would have made to the lives of his family and friends, and as a nurse, I imagine, to many patients. During this time, he shared acts of kindness and caring. These are years during which he was able to touch and perhaps mold many lives, perhaps more so in his life as a nurse. We believe as Christians that such acts are never lost to God. For as our Lord reminds us, as much as we do for the least, we do it for God. All the lives we influence for good along life's journey are lives influenced for God. And so in spite of all the loss and the grief today, we can focus on life and remember that the time Kenrick shared with us was time lent by God, and it was not a waste. For whenever we are able to live life with a purpose, whenever we are able to extend a helping hand, we are showing the love of God that is at work in God's world, love that is at work through us. So we are now focusing then on what that great gift that is called eternal life. But eternal life for the Christian is not simply something that happens after we die. It is about God's presence in this world and in the world to come. It is about being instruments of God's presence in this world. For we get that foretaste of eternal life when we experience those great Christian qualities of love and sharing and kindness. When we experience compassion, forgiveness, that is what we understand when we talk about eternal life. But the Christian teaching about eternal life also reminds us that there's far more to human life than what we experience in this world. This more for the Christian is grounded in Jesus Christ, our Lord, who overcame death and the grave. And perhaps it's no coincidence this evening that we are in what the Christian church calls the Easter season. We are celebrating now this season that reminds us of hope, that reminds us that God indeed rose from the dead in Jesus. Here's a message then of the one who gives us the hope that not even death can destroy. It is in his life that we see how caring and sharing and compassion and forgiveness and reconciliation and kindness can help us to deal with our daily challenges. For just as we can think of God's presence in terms of caring and sharing, love and compassion as we go through life, we can also think of him as present at death and even beyond death. It is the life of Jesus that helps us to make sense of all the experiences of life, especially the experiences of loss through death. It is his life that can help us when we lose a relative or a friend in death to hold together life and death and the hope of life eternal. We hold these together, although they may seem like conflicting parts of a huge, huge problem. It is with this Christian conviction that we are called to live our lives then as bold Christians, confident Christians. It is a conviction that we are called to share with others and with the world, where many persons still find it difficult to believe that there's more to life than what we can see and touch and hear and smell. That there's more to life that we cannot explain. We, as mortal human beings then, will never be able to sort out the mysteries of life and death. I know we rely a lot on science. We always ask the question, what does science say? But sometimes we cannot always explain on this side of heaven about all the challenges that we face in life. But perhaps we do not need to. For with our faith grounded firmly in Jesus our Lord, we can face each day. We can face the tragedies of life fully convinced that God still is with us at every step of our way. We can therefore thank God this evening for the life of Kenrick and remain fully convinced that his death cannot in any way cancel out the Christian conviction that God is always here with us. It cannot cancel out Kenrick's contribution to the world and surely cannot shake our faith in life everlasting. The Christian conviction is that life is stronger than death. So our memories of our loved ones, or memories of Kenrick, or experiences of them can be far more powerful an influence than their death. The Christian teaching is that death has been conquered by Jesus, our Lord. For in him, God has removed the sting of death, as St. Paul calls it. And we thank God then for the life of our dearly departed brother, Kenrick. And we pray that God will accept him as his own. We thank God for allowing him to spend those 80 years among us. And it's with this confidence that we commit our dearly departed brother, Kenrick, this evening into God's safe keeping. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. I invite you to stand. As we affirm our faith as Christians by saying together the Apostles' Creed, found on page 6, that reminds us of our belief in the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting. As we say then, I believe in God, the Father Almighty. I believe in Jesus Christ.
End of each prayer, your response would be, hear us, Lord. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Kenrick, and dry the tears of those who weep. Hear us, Lord. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raised the dead to life. Raise our brother to eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. He was nourished with your body and the blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
Continue our prayers. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Kenrick, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust and your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Please stand for the commendation.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, Henrik, with your saints. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of humankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, hallelujah. Servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, by the sighing of life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We join now in the words of the Lord's Prayer, the prayer which Jesus taught us to say. Our Father. Deliver your servant, Henrik, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in eternal habitation, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God forever and ever. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Henrik. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in life. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Just before we have our closing hymn for the service in the church, we proceed, of course, for the interment in the graveyard of the church. I'd like, on behalf of Dean Jeffrey and Reverend LaVaughn and the entire parish family of St. Leonard, to offer condolences to the family of Kenrick, and on their behalf to also thank those of you who made a special effort to be here this evening. We have as our final hymn here, Have Thine Own Way, Lord.
doors to the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen. He will light those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you." And greatly boy, in the paradise, may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my
Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this: blessed are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer, forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure uncertain hope of resurrection to eternal life to our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Kenrick Leroy, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Kenrick and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray, Almighty God, with whom so live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, with whom the souls of the faithful are in just and felicity. Give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, before all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The first hymn in our At the Graveside hymn, When Peace Like a River Attendeth My Way.
Yeah.
When the world is called up yonder.
Thank you. When my way groweth drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. My work is all done, and my race here is run. Let me see by the light thou hast shone. That fair city so bright, where the lamp is the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I'm weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Safe forevermore with past unfold. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Thank you.
You.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us say the closing prayer. Remember, O Lord, this your servant, Kenrick, who has gone before us with the sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to him and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his light upon him and give him peace. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. Let light perpetual shine upon him. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Amen.
Yes, good evening. I want to express or have thanks for all those who came to the ceremony, family, relatives, God's son and his wife and family, Mark and my wife, and the nursing home family who they came out. I am so glad for your support. I know that he was a bit hesitant at first, but y'all just gelled and y'all became one happy family. So I want to thank all of y'all, for your comfort, your support, your well wishes, and may God all bless you. Go in peace. Thank you.
Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.